Actually, Irkam found this apartment, and when I came in, I was very, very happy to see this green wall in front of me. This is my dream. I need for composition a table, which is big, which this table is in exactly in a good size, could be bigger, but it's enough. And I need a window. And this window is special because I have so much space, and the space is green. It is quite a dream. I don't need much more than this. I need my paper. I need my pencil. I have a whole bunch of pencils and erasers. These are erasers. I have many others. I'm always looking in shops for pencils and erasers. And that's all. And that's how I compose. My parents came to Israel around the time when Israel was founded, so around 48. And yeah, they came from Poland and Russia. So when I was about 5 years old, or four, I'm not sure when, I was sent by my mother to learn ballet. And I was there for a year, and the ballet teacher invited my mom and said to her this. She said, you know, your daughter is not going to be a ballet dancer, unfortunately. But whenever the pianist makes a mistake, she goes like this. So maybe you should teach her piano instead of ballet. My father is the musical root. He has an amazing ear. I'm not sure it's an absolute hearing, but probably very close. And he played accordion when I was a child, and we had always people singing Russian songs in our place when I was young. Already from the age of four, me and my sister were singing with two voices together all these Russian songs. And I was always the second voice, you know, the one that was complicated to sing. I studied in Israel with Abel Ehrlich, who came from Germany and was a very special human being. He was crazy. Everybody knew that. But in the best sense of the word, extremely spontaneous. And the students loved him because he was not making himself into the great master. He was a human being first. And he treated us as people, and he was very anxious, not anxious, but he put a lot of accent on our different personalities and how to make it so that each of us can speak what we have to say, what we especially have to say individually. Then I went and studied with, in the same academy, the Rubin Academy Tel Aviv, I studied with Yitzhak Sadai, who was exactly the opposite. Instead of the freedom, complete freedom that we got from Ehrlich, he was extremely exacting, and one of the first things he asked me to do was to give him an account in a piece I wrote, a large piece. Why did I do everything? Every note I had to explain why I wrote it, every dynamic, every rhythm. It was a huge undertaking, which was very, very helpful for me in the long run. So it's not like he asked me to do it every time, but one time, it was kind of a touchdown of reasoning and understanding that actually there is a reason behind every action we are doing intuitively, and the intuition is something very, very wise that has its own mechanisms of calculating and deciding on what's right and what's wrong. So then I went to Germany and I studied with Dieter Schnebel, which was again going to complete freedom. Dieter was wonderful, and it was just the feeling of joy of being able to do what I need and want to do. It was very interesting to work with him, even for the short time that we worked together. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a very vital household, and I think that we always had the feeling that we are kind of guerrilla workers. And even if the musics are very different, there is this connection that we are working for the same thing. There is a kind of a underneath understanding that is not connected to the difference in what we do. And our son partakes in it. Same thing, none of us is doing mainstream music, which is entertaining in the pure way. Even though I think that both of us, Steven and me, have learned a lot from Ko, because he was working very much in the area of indie music and pop music, and he brought to the house a lot of things that we didn't know before. And also kind of enlarged my perception of what is done in pop music today, which at times is extremely interesting, and you can find very serious people in that area. So this is how the house functions. Three individuals, each does their work, but we gain a lot from input. It's almost like a pact that we are fighting for the same thing, in a way. Never just go by inspiration and intuition. That is not interesting for me. Intuition is extremely interesting and important because it can be analyzed, opening the door to further intuitive moves. So it is always a search to really be courageous and go follow your intuition, but then understand it and act upon what you understand, open the door to even more bold moves. That is for me a very, very pregnant way of progressing in creative thinking. You did that type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
My feeling that it's not... No. This is more like...
Big ones, isolated ones.
Yeah, okay. So I'm not talking, this we have to talk about. These are the things that are dragged.
Mm-hmm.
We have to talk about those because I think these are, but these are so great and they are just in the end.
Ah, yes. And you would like that they appear before.
You know, this kind of, I tell you what I like. It's exactly like a painted, because this is more horizontal.
Mm-hmm.
This is a bit more vertical too, but basically it is
it's horizontal. Yeah.
And this is totally vertical.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And those objects are in between, vertical to horizontal.
Okay.
So those vertical, I think we benefit a lot from them, and that's why this idea of yours was very brilliant, to put them, you know, chuck.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we can use more of those. And also, you always make them as boom, just right, and then cut, boom. Maybe one of them can stay for a longer time, for a moment, and hide everything that was before, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So this maybe we can do towards the end, but from the beginning, it would be really
just
nice to have.
Cuts.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, working with Haya is very special. there is, for me, most of the time, a sort of a creative and collaborative role. And I work with her, creating things like we do together. There's some stuff. Actually, in fact, in our work, I'm an active part of the creation. In our collaboration, it's not the same with other composers.
I'm not interested in creating music which is entertaining, attractive, makes our day sweeter. There is a lot of wonderful music which does that much better than I can do. The music gives a kind of life experience, and if a piece is really good, if music is really strong, it really puts one in touch with a life texture, a life fabric that one didn't know before. That is the contribution I can give, as small as it is, or, you know. When I was in Vienna, one of my students, Uday Krishna Kumar, came one day to a lesson and said, you know, I just read a book which I think you must read because you have a connection to that book. And I loved the writing, and I thought it was extremely precise and very rich and very condensed, really like a piece of earth that has so many things in it. And it has the smell, and it has the touch of something, as we talked before, something real. So from that moment, I read the whole book, and there was a special story, Homecoming, that immediately when I read, I knew that story, I would like to do something with it. I thought that it was also written so musically. There was such a rhythm. Everything was really, it was not only the text, it was all the subtext that was really conveying that type of running in that area, the cut sentences, the rhythm in which the words kind of rolled. And that was my way of actually getting to know Tsan Shui. And then when I wrote her and I wrote her about my impressions from her writing, she wrote me back and said that I was her ideal reader. And then she got my music and she started writing me back and was so taken by the work as well. And I felt that her reaction was so powerful that somehow we came together. And when I wrote her about Infinite Now and I said, you know, I'm going to cut a lot from the text and it's together with other texts, she said, do whatever you want. You have my complete permission. And I was so happy to hear that. So I'm hoping that she will come to the premiere. We will see, but we have never met. But we have had this really beautiful meeting of our artistic selves, which was very powerful, I think.